The doctor had just left the room. The monitors were beeping and humming. There you were, lying in that hospital bed, letting go of life. Mom. The one that cared for me. The one that gave me her love, unconditionally, lying there. And now it was my turn, my chance to be completely there for you. Life was coming full circle. Sitting at your bedside, I was lost in thought. For as long as I can remember, I recall you telling me that I was your miracle baby, that you had actually chosen me. You never hid the fact that I had been adopted. So how, with all that love, had everything gone so wrong? How did my life get so far off track? How had I become a monster, turning against everything that was good, against you, against everything that I knew deep in my soul to be right? It all began with a few white lies. The lies got bigger until they became an uncontrollable wildfire, the turmoil so deep that I completely lost my way. Addiction was a natural fit for the insanity that was brewing within me. It started with wacky weed, and later, the devil's drug, methamphetamine, bound me. The monster within me grew mightier. Everything I cared for, my kids, my job, my friends, took a back seat. Darkness became normal. Slowly, I resigned myself to believe that who I had become was all that I would ever be. The more I tried to escape it, the tighter the grip of my addiction became. I didn't recognize the face in the mirror. I watched as my children seemed to be resigned to the fact that life as they knew it, wanted it, might never be normal again. Then came that fateful night. A 9mm gun pointed at my head. A suicidal maniac shooting at me and two of my friends. And then, Kevin, lying there, his body twisted, his lifeless eyes wide open with a look of pure terror still in them. Me and my other friend barely survived. The police found that we were the victims of a senseless, violent act. But I was tormented. I felt I was the responsible party that somehow failed his friend. Over time, the fact that I was spared death only reinforced the lie, the idea that I was stronger than my addiction. I remember the day that you confronted me. I had hid it for so long from you, but now you growled, "Get out! You need help!" Did you really know how sick I was? How twisted? I believed the lie, believed that there was nothing wrong. I was normal, right? Not long after that, I had no choice but to check myself into drug treatment. I was told that I had a disease, the disease of addiction. I was mad. No, I was afraid to believe that this could be true. Who were these people? How dare they? I'm not one of them. I have a disease. Yet, as the days turned into weeks and then into months, I was beginning to see reality. Maybe there was hope that life might be normal again. I felt as if I had been given a new lease on life, and I knew that it had to be done. When my son turned 5, I stopped using alcohol, marijuana, meth, everything. But the wreckage of my past was immense. I soon came to understand that the consequences of my life's choices would be bigger, so much bigger than I could have ever imagined. I had to face the judge. I truly believed that I had nothing to worry about. Instead, I was told that I would have to serve 5 years in prison. After everything, the shooting, overcoming the grip of addiction, and surviving it, I thought that I was done with that chapter of my life. But now I was at a crossroad. Would I have the courage to accept the sentence as a trade-off for all of my life choices, or would my soul die there? In that holding cell, I got on my knees, crying out that I couldn't do it any longer, that I was tired, that I needed to turn everything over and trust someone other than myself. For the first time, I surrendered. The monitors were still beeping, the nurses coming in and out. I took your hand. You were the one who believed that with hope, anything was possible. You taught me to never stop believing, to never give up hope. I found strength in the wisdom of your words. The vigil that I kept with you these last 3 weeks at your bedside revealed more to me about myself than the previous 20 years of my life. For all this time, I'd been tormented, fighting a raging battle to run, to get away, for fear that if I didn't, somehow, the adopted son would be sent back. Then, God, I will never forget it. I walked into your room and kissed your forehead for the last time, saying goodbye once and for all. It was then, only then, when life became death, that finally I realized what unconditional love meant, and I felt at peace.
Up high.